The Warren Cup. There are other Roman silver cups in the British Museum and other museum collections around the world, but this one is unique. What makes it exceptional is its decoration. The bowl of the cup is decorated with two scenes of a man and a youth having sex. The detailed relief scenes are depicted with great naturalism, requiring extraordinary skill on the part of the maker. On one side, a younger male lowers himself down onto the lap of his older, bearded partner, who wears a wreath in his hair. To the right, a young boy, perhaps a servant, peers in towards them through a partially opened door. On the other side, two young males are engaged in sex. The rooms are well appointed with drapery. The musical instruments suggest a sophisticated and leisured setting. The same-sex scenes on the Warren Cup reflect a Roman representation of the Greek past, where a mature male lover, Erastes, would often form a relationship with a younger man, Eromenos. Although male same-sex relationships were also an accepted part of life in the Roman world, this more formalized Greek type of relationship did not exist. A Roman man was free to choose sexual partners of either gender. Male same-sex relationships were not unusual. But for Romans, it was important that men were dominant both socially and sexually. The Warren Cup is a luxury drinking vessel that belongs to the sphere of elite dining and entertaining some 2,000 years ago. Wine accompanied the meal throughout, and we can only imagine the atmosphere of such an occasion. The cup holds a fair slug of wine. Silver cups like this were intended to display the wealth, status, and culture of their owners to their guests. It is easy to imagine the diners, both men and women, reclining on their couches with splendid cups like this, gleaming in the lamplight, and providing a conversation starter, allowing the hosts to demonstrate their knowledge and taste. Similar scenes of male lovemaking survive on other tableware made in cameo glass for the wealthy, or much cheaper mass-produced ceramics for the less well-off. This exquisite cup made in AD 10 is said to have been found at Bitir, close to Jerusalem, in the early 20th century. It seems likely that the cup was hidden during a period of unrest and never reclaimed by its owner. If the cup had not been hidden, it would probably have been melted down and the silver reused. It was bought by the American art collector Edward Perry Warren, who lived in the south of England at Lewes. In the decades after Warren's death, at the time when homosexuality was still illegal in the UK, it was impossible to find a buyer for the cup. In 1953, the cup was sent to New York in an attempt to sell it there, but it was refused entry by US Customs and sent back to England. Shortly afterwards, it was offered to the British Museum, who declined the chance to purchase it. Fortunately, in 1999, the British Museum took up a second opportunity to acquire the Warren Cup, then the most expensive acquisition it had made, and it has been on public display ever since.